I wanted to come in and ask specifically about your role, Bhaskar, in the coming general election, because I saw a reference to Jacobin and Chapo and the whole sort of left media sphere. I think it was from Matt Iglesias from Vox. And he was saying that, you know, even if Bernie endorses Biden, there's going to be some holdouts who are unwilling to do so. And I'm wondering, you know, how are you thinking about this strategically? Because one argument is to say, well, for one, you're not infused by this guy for obvious reasons. Mm-hmm. So why would you go out and bat for him and campaign for him? The other argument is, you know, one of the arguments as to how the left can have leverage in the next round of primaries is to say, look, you need us to campaign for you, so vote for our candidate. Mm-hmm. But also there could be a third sort of consideration to make, which is many people are saying, you know, one of the limits of Bernie Sanders was that he wasn't seen as a Democrat. He wasn't seen as someone who plays for that team. So do you think there will be some people potentially on the Bernie wing who are going to go all out to show, look, we are proper Democrats. We will campaign properly for Biden. Bring us into the fold with the idea that will give them more legitimacy the next time around?
On the last count, I don't think so. I think it is a complicated situation because we should say that these two candidates are not the same. You know, Biden is a lesser evil compared to Donald Trump. That is, in fact, true. It's true on everything. Even this whitewashing of Trump's record on imperialism, which makes it seem like he's some sort of anti-imperialist force. No, they're both bad on foreign policy. There's nothing good about what Donald Trump is doing there. But beyond that, as Marxists, we should think about social forces. Now, one is a centrist candidate who we don't like for all sorts of reasons, who's going to accumulate whatever institutional forces exist in the progressive movement in the U.S. A lot of them are NGOs and other groups, but also are trade unions. They're all going to back and rally behind Joe Biden. He's going to, in some way, have to be accountable to them, at least not in that direction from time to time. Of course, we know the record of betrayal from Democrats, just like the record of betrayal from labor leaders in the past. On the other hand, is a guy who's a right populist leader with a coalition that has every big capitalist in the country behind him, and in a coalition that has really nasty, virulently right-wing racist elements behind him. So put it that way, I mean, who would we rather be in opposition to? I'd rather be in opposition just for the sake of the constituencies and the social base and the working people of this country that we say we're engaging in politics for, with Joe Biden. Now, I can't, though, go out there and canvass for Joe Biden like a Joe Biden supporter. There's nothing in Joe Biden's platform that's a big concession to the left. There's nothing in there that signals that he wants our support. Now, if I was in a swing state and my vote could make the difference between Trump or Biden getting elected, sure, I'll pull the lever for Biden. This isn't about me and what makes me feel good morally. You know, it might make me feel good morally to write in Bernie Sanders, but politics isn't about that. But what I will do in November, even though I won't canvass for Joe Biden, and also because I'm in New York, I won't vote for the guy, I will canvass for down-ballot progressive candidates, and I will canvass to the extent we can with coronavirus, you know, actually go out there and knock on doors and talk to people. I will do it for Medicare for All and for our key issues, and I will try to cement a base around the Bernie Sanders movement so we can figure out how do we regroup left populists and democratic socialists and others who want an alternative within and outside the Democratic Party. I think that's the way forward. Bernie Sanders will be out there and he will be actively campaigning for Joe Biden. I think we shouldn't oppose him for that. That's what he said he'll do. He did 40 events for Hillary Clinton. Don't believe, you know, liberals when they tell you he undermined Hillary Clinton. No, he was out there campaigning for her. That's what he's going to do. And he's going to take far more of the base with him than people on the far left can. But our role is a little bit different. We're trying to build an opposition movement. I think by saying there's no difference between Trump and Biden, we could end up being scapegoats for Biden's own deficiencies. We have to prevent that. But there's no way I think we should encourage DSA chapters to go out there and actively expend our finite resources canvassing for Biden when we could canvass for good down-ballot progressive candidates and for our issues like Medicare for All.